Does it constitute five roster changes, a lot of changes today for tomorrow's game?
Five roster changes. Is it that many? I don't count. We just got to make sure the guys are in ready to play. So we never get into who's changed, where there's changed. They practice, and we're confident, excuse me, that each guy can play. So it's football.
Can you even come close to expect the same production against their team from where they were back in week one to where they are now?
You know, I would never look back, Jamie, to even say what the production would be one way or the next. There are two teams who've made changes. They made some roster changes also in the last couple of hours. So when you look at that, you just each game's different. You know, this could be the lowest scoring game of the year, you know, and one team wins. You just don't know. Each game's going to be different. So we just had to focus on that game itself and go from there.
Are these kind of make or break games for people like Taj and Jeffries Harris, or is this sort of just one or two or three game sort of tryout or project?
Well, I think each guy, you know, I could talk to him about opportunities. Each guy, you know, it's depending on what he does with that opportunity. If he takes a hold to it, you look at like a guy like Corey Sheets, he got an opportunity in the preseason and he hadn't looked back yet. So some guys get opportunity and they take off. Other guys, you know, they simply need one or two more opportunities. So it depends on what they do and then how the roster looks when we get back from the break.
How about you assess where Andy Fantuz plays now compared to that game one, the first game of the season?
Well, you know, if you look at that, I think it was more so just, you know, those guys being in a new offense and learning each other. You know, Andy's done, you know, no different than he did the first game. You know, Hank's just find him a little bit more. And I think Hank's got a better groove now. So we know they're very productive. They're probably I know they're the fastest starting offense in the CFL right now. So that's just something that we have to, you know, try to hold them down in that area.
What does Andy Fantuz do as a receiver?
Well, Andy has size. You know, he's one of the bigger receivers in the league. So he's a body. He's a target that I know Hank will try to use and find. And speed is something he has good speed for his size. So, I mean, he's a good player in this league, and he possesses some good tools.
What do you expect the reaction to Andy will be, and what are your thoughts about what you'd like to see?
Well, what I like to see is something totally different. But, no, you'd like to see, you know, I know that you're probably going to have 2,000 or 3,000 fans that are coming just to see Andy and his return. You know, the fans here are loyal, and they're loyal to their players. So, you know, I doubt just because he changed right there, you know, changed colors that they would change on that quick. But for the most part, hopefully the other 29, 30 gives him the same thing that Hank's going to get.
Corey, they're obviously a much better team than what they were in week one. How much better of a team are you since week one?
I think that's why we got to play the game. Just, you know, that's what tells us who's the best team. You know, you could be best going in. Everybody's going to say they're the best, and you don't know what roster changes, what roster moves, or what game plan will work. The best is simply who on that day and who wins the game.
You win this year, got the best record in the league going into the bye week. How important would that be for you? How symbolic would that be?
Well, you know, the thing, that we talked about, in the offseason, you know, you talk about the bye week, and it's a different bye week than it's been in the past. But the best opportunity we have right now is to go 4-1, and our worst opportunity this week is to go 3-2. So when you look at either one of those, you know, that's a good opportunity to be going into the bye, knowing that you're going to have a winning season at that point.